Hi, I'm Angela Druckman, an Agile coach and trainer with CollabNet, and welcome to our Agile Tips series. One of the cornerstones of Scrum is the self-managed team. And managers often ask me, how can I support my teams in doing a better job of self-organizing and self-managing? Well, there are actually several things you can do to support your teams as they learn these behaviors and get better at them. The first is you can practice the art of asking questions rather than giving directives. This can be tough to do for managers. When you see a team doing something that you think isn't going to work out, for example, they're committing to more than you think they can really deliver, it's so tempting to step in and say, no, you guys can't deliver 50 story points worth of work. I know you can't. I want you to commit to 20 instead. But if you do that, the teams never go through that decision-making process themselves. Instead, reframe your idea. Try saying, wow, last time you committed to 50 story points, but it looks like you only delivered 20. Is there a reason you think you could deliver 50 this time? Just framing your question that way, as a question, helps the team think through their reasoning process, and it will help them do a better job of making decisions themselves in the future. Another thing you can do as a manager to support your teams in their agile behavior is to respect their boundaries when they are what's known as in sprint. So they're in the middle of a sprint and they've made commitments and now they're working hard to deliver on those commitments. It's very important as a manager that you don't step in and interfere with that. And there are lots of ways that we can be tempted to do that. We can be worried that the team isn't doing the right activities and we can step in and micromanage them and tell them to do other things. Or we can step in and pull them off the project and say, yeah, I know you're in the middle of a sprint, but I need you to work on this other project just for a couple of days. All of those things really interfere with the team's ability to self-manage. Think about it. They've come together as a group and made a commitment, and now you're making it hard for them to deliver on that commitment. So really do your best to respect the boundaries of the team when they're in sprint. Finally, one thing you can do for your teams that will help the individuals on it really learn to think in a more team-oriented way is to reward team-oriented behavior rather than individual-oriented behavior. It's interesting. Most organizations have an entire reward structure that's set up in what I like to refer to as a me, not we culture. What it means is it definitely rewards the individual and the individual's behaviors, which means things like mentoring other people, things like being a team member, things like pairing with people and helping other people grow are not as well rewarded. So as a manager, you want to find opportunities to reward team-oriented behavior. To do so is going to send the message to the individual team members that you value them not just as an individual, but as part of this wonderful microcosm called the self-managed team. For more Agile tips, please visit us at www.collab.net/agiletips.